Hey friends, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited that you're here with me today because I'm going to be going into a really cool topic about spiritual awakening, what it actually is, what it means, because I know that spirituality, spiritual speaking, all of this holistic health stuff is getting really popular right now. And I know if I was to be in maybe your shoes 5, 10 years ago, I would have no idea what the heck everyone's talking about. And so in these next few video series, I want to talk more about what spiritual awakening actually means. That way you guys have a better understanding of what this journey is going to look like for you moving forward. Now, spiritual awakening is so important because this is kind of the journey back to our authentic self. I believe that over our life, from the time we're born until we grow into adults, we're being shaped and formed by everything that's going on around us. And our perception of reality usually becomes skewed due to a lot of challenging life events that we go through, big or small. And so the process of becoming spiritually awoke or woke or awakening is the process of removing those old versions of yourself that no longer serve you and truly stepping into your real being, the real authentic self that you truly are within. Now, to put it simply, awakening to reality is what spiritual awakening is. And all I can say about this is you start to open your eyes to things that you may have not seen before, whether it's the dynamics in a relationship, how you played a role in something, maybe your viewpoint or idea on certain things that you used to really believe in that maybe you don't agree with anymore. It might be how you used to treat yourself or other people versus how you want to start to treat people now that you've been able to look at yourself with more of a clear lens, and also not placing so much judgment on yourself. And when this real authentic self starts to form, you start to find a lot more self-discovery, empowerment, and this new almost purpose and vision to keep moving forward, to keep further identifying who you really are. It's a really fun process, actually. Now, I broke this down into a few different topic ideas to keep it a little bit more simple for everybody. First one I want to talk about is your inner quest that you're going to go on. So I mentioned that this is a spiritual awakening within, and this has nothing to do with anybody else, and you're not doing this awakening for anyone else. This is coming from deep within because you have started to notice that throughout your day, throughout your life, there's a contrast to these emotions that you're feeling. Maybe you start to feel a lot of negative emotions and you want to feel more positive ones. So you start to notice more of what you don't like, which moves you closer towards what you do like. During this inner process, you're also going to find a lot about yourself, such as some of your own insecurities. You learn more about your inner child and also shadow work, projections, and perceptions. And when you really can start to step into those, take ownership of those, and start to really self-identify with those and work out of them, you are going to start to change as a person so quickly you might not even recognize yourself within a few months. That's generally what happens when I work with my clients. Within 3 months, their purpose has shifted so much that they're just like this completely new energy once again. And the second part of spiritual awakening is about embracing the dark and the light, because not one is good or bad. And that's the biggest thing, is not placing labels or judgment on yourself or on others, especially during a journey like this. It's really important to find compassion within yourself, because without that, you're not going to get too far during your spiritual awakening. Because spiritual awakening isn't about being right. It isn't about doing what's good. It's about finding yourself and starting to shed those old layers, whether they seem negative or not. And when you start to face your shadows, you're going to notice that there's a completely new wisdom that starts to arise within you. Usually the things that used to get you really upset don't really even bother you at all anymore. It's a sense of freedom that starts to arise. The third I'd like to cover is the expansion of your awareness. And what I mean by this is you just start to see the world with a different colored glasses. So that might mean you used to see the world as challenging, you have to work really hard to get what you want, you know, life's tough, just suck it up. And you might start to experience a feeling of life is really awesome. Life can be easy. Things come to me so simply. And when I put my mind towards something positive, it's going to be mine. And so your shift of perspective, your awareness to current reality starts to change. And this awareness creates more presence And that presence, being in the present moment, just creates so much more happiness within. The next one I'd like to talk about is the interconnectedness of everything in the universe. Now, this is a really interesting topic to cover. Some people have their own beliefs and religious views, and this isn't about telling anyone what is right or wrong. All this means is that during a spiritual awakening, there is this connection that you feel between everything. You start to notice that there's a connection between you and the person, you and a stranger, you and your family members, you and the earth. It's just this way that you start to perceive others, and you only want to give what you want to receive. You start to feel like everything can work together. There's these signs and synchronicities and symptoms that are showing you that the world is working with you, God is working with you, your life is working for you. And this is going to bring so much more positivity to yourself and to the world. And spiritual awakening is about challenges. That's the next topic. Challenges are good. And as you continue down your path, there's two things that happen. Challenges start to, it seems like, happen a little less because you are able to overcome those challenges a lot easier. And sometimes those challenges, even though they're happening less, they might feel bigger, they might feel harder, because once again, you're releasing and letting go of all these things that used to hold you down. And it's almost like once you uncover one layer of the onion, and there's another layer and another layer and another. And when you start to transcend those levels, each level sometimes gets a little bit more difficult. But the cool thing is that you have created the skills to overcome those first few levels, so now you have the skills to go on to the next. This kind of reminds me of Donkey Kong. Like, you know, you back when we were younger, you would be on one level, and then to get to that second or third or fourth level, you'd have to get better. If you're not getting better at the game, you're not leveling up. And so as you're leveling up, you're gaining those skills, gaining that momentum, and you know, over time, it's just really simple for you to be able to accomplish a lot of the things that you have set yourself out to do. And this is all happening because you have gone through your awakening and have done all those first steps that we talked about. And lastly, this is a continuous journey. Spiritual awakening isn't, hey, I'm healed. It's, hey, I'm healing and I am healed, but the healing is never going to end. Because like I said, that onion, there always is going to be a layer for you to work on, another way that you can show up better and more like yourself and more loving and caring to other people. There's always a process of self-discovery happening within, and that's what keeps the fire alive within you. When you can truly find joy in knowing that this is a continuous process, that it's going to continue to challenge you to keep digging deeper, you're going to be pretty excited about the challenges that are coming your way and how amazing life can really be with all this power that you do truly have. When you feel empowered, when you can find that spiritual awakening within and start to run towards it instead of away from it, your life is going to shift. My life has shifted. I see my clients' lives shift so quickly. And so remember, it's all interconnected. Everything does have a meaning. It all has a purpose. And you could either look at it with a negative viewpoint or a positive viewpoint. However, if you just start to move towards it, whether you're looking positive or negative, you're going to get a little bit closer to where you want to go. Hope this video helped. I would love to hear more from you guys. Put a comment below. Let me know what your thoughts are about spiritual awakening. If you have any other questions that I can cover in my future topics. And one thing I would like to invite you guys to do is I have a free 5 daily journal prompts that you must download on beingbecomes.com. I will go ahead and link it below, and that will give you access to this really amazing PDF workbook that I created for you to start to get to know yourself a little bit more and stay on track with yourself and your goals.